Hello everyone, welcome to the Federated Model Aggregation Service example tutorial. My name is Kenny Bean, I'm one of the main developers on the repository, and today we're going to be looking at how to start up the service as well as clients that interact with the service locally. That way we can see how the service works, how it runs within your console, as well as how the clients interact with the service itself. So everything can be found in this README right here, but what we're going to do is we're going to go and CD into the examples. We're going to go to the Django deployment, and then we're going to just run the make complete install command, which is going to allow the service to be set up and ready to be started by the next command we're going to do after. So let's run this.
Once you've ran the startup script, the script is going to prompt you for a username and password. This username and password are the credentials that you're going to use to access the service in the browser later. So you want to make sure you remember these. For the point of this tutorial, I'm going to make my username username. And then email address doesn't really matter as long as it follows the guidelines that we have for emails in Django. So I'm just blahblah@gmail.com. Not a real email, but whatever. You're going to set the password. In a minute, you're going to see that my password is not going to pass the password checks that exist for the system. You can choose to bypass these. However, what the system is telling you is that your password is not safe enough to use in a production level system. So I'm going to bypass it by pressing Y and hitting enter. But if you would like a better password that's more production level, you can also press no and redo that step. So press enter. Okay, and now the service is going to start up and we'll be able to log in.
Finally, once your service is all installed and your username and password is set up, you can now run the make start service local command and that will start the service. All right, once the service is spun up, you're going to want to go to your local host port 8000 to log in with the credentials that you set for yourself. So what we're going to do is we're going to use username and then our password that we set before that will allow us to log in. And you'll see this screen. This screen shows you that the service is all spun up and you're ready to go. Just to check it out, you can look at federated models. There's none in here yet because we haven't created any or initialized any of the service. Same thing with model aggregates, model artifacts, and model updates. You can see yourself in here. So you have my username, the email address that I set, and then staff status is checkmarked. And now we're going to move on to spinning up the clients and creating our own experiment. Okay, so now that we have the service spun up on this terminal, we're going to create a new terminal at the top level of the repository to spin up an experiment and start some clients so that they can iterate through a federated learning experiment. So let's go to the examples folder again, go to the client examples, and then Python client directory. And now we're going to run our run example script. You have run example, we're going to run three clients. This is our username from before, and then the base URL that we're using for our service, and the number of epochs that we want to run on each client. So we're going to start that up, and it's going to ask you for the password that you initialized the service with so that it can create a federated learning experiment for you. So we're going to enter our password. Now you can see the model ID here, as well as the number of clients I spun up, and their IDs as well. Now that the clients are running and the service is all spun up, I wanted to show you the federated model we created. So if you look here, we have a bunch of model tests. If we go to the latest one, we can see that the model ID is the same as the model ID that we saw in the terminal. We can go to our model updates, and we can see that there are some pending updates that are waiting to be aggregated, as well as some aggregates that are already created. These are the model test aggregate models. So it's all of the client's updates aggregated together to make one model, and then it's sent back down to the clients so that they can iterate through the federated learning process. Okay, so just to give you an idea of what it looks like when these three clients are running, you can see that there are some validation printouts that you can see that the models are improving upon. It's starting to get these hashes, some social security numbers, it's starting to find MAC addresses and things like that. So all these different colors are used for the entities. You'll be able to see an improvement on the generalization of the model while the clients don't have access to all the entities. They only have access to one of the entities. So that is pretty much the end of the tutorial. Hope this was helpful. Again, my name is Kenny Bean, and these are examples of the Federated Model Aggregation Service running. I hope you enjoyed it.